there will be an obstinate, awful thing from my soul. I am on fire for religious freedom. That's the glorious cause. The gun and the bayonet alone will finish the contest in which we are engaged. All power is derived from the people.
Before them today is the final document, drafted by Jefferson, edited by Franklin and Adams, the result of many months of political wrangling, but we have finally come to a consensus.
We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
Most Americans are familiar with these famous words from the Declaration of Independence, but we did not know what them meant. A very angry, hostile, and confrontational document, words that threatened the solidly entrenched, long-enduring, and far-reaching British Empire.
The Declaration lists 18 major grievances and another 9 specific offenses against King George.
To prove this, let the facts be submitted to a candid world. For quartering large bodies of armed troops among us.
For cutting off our trade with all parts of the world.
For imposing taxes on us without our consent.
For depriving us, in many cases, of the benefit of a trial by jury.
For transporting us beyond sea. Tried for attended offenses.
For suspending our own legislatures, he has abdicated government here by declaring us out of his protection and waging war against us.
The spirit of revolt is in the air. God has been cast, and now there is no turning back.
A prince whose character is thus marked by having acted to be defiant and tyrant is unfit to be the ruler of the people. My dearest wish is for my country to become independent.
Sailors, well, live or die, survive or perish with my country is my unalterable determination.
As I believe the voice of all sensible and honest men, I vote for independence.
My hand trembles, but my heart is not.
Gentlemen, we must now hang together. Or we shall most assuredly all men suffer.
With nothing but hope, an undisciplined army and navy, uncertain financial support from other nations, and a mere piece of parchment declaring their intentions, these men will go from this room, gathering their compatriots along the way, to face down the mightiest colonial power on earth.
It's over. The American Revolution will last for 8 years at a terrible cost in life, lives, and fortune. Of this, we have 30 colonists in America. 6,800 were killed in battle, some 8,000 were wounded, and about 10,000 died.